Published all over the world in multi-language. When we talk about the raid, first of all, we know about the climate change. All of you know climate change is a buzzword, which is over-talked, over-searched, and over-concerned at present moment. After the publication of scientific facts and figures about the growth of temperature 2 degrees from 2 degrees centigrade to 3 degrees centigrade, and also negative growth rate of the rainfall and the growth of the climatic disaster events and its losses in the world. In that condition, Professor Stern and Elise have projected the temperature growth rate will be from 2 degrees to the 3 degrees centigrade in future. In other words, the climate change will be continued in future. It means what? It means the climatic disaster will happen more and more in future. And in this situation, all of you know, we can listen some news of the melting glaciers, disturbance of the cyclones, and also the earthquakes, and floods, landslides, number of the such types of the events we listen. And all these are byproduct of the climate change. And it is, it has been made complicated by climate change. Before some years ago, we just, accepted as a, landslide, as a flood, as a, natural disasters, please remember. And in this situation, such tough, climate change, had made loss to the society in terms of GDP, in terms of house, in terms of assets, in terms of the other different types of things. Similarly, disasters have also, you know, such types of the impact to our human society and civilization. In this way, you know, climate change and climate-induced, you know, disaster have been a, you know, unpredictable threat to the society. And when we talk about the why, the growth of the climate change, we found the scientific facts and figures and its evidences of the growth of carbon emission and F gases. And all these, you know, carbon emission and F gases produced by the two ways, one is the human activities, another is the natural way. We love development, we love quality of life, we love other different types of the advancement. And when to, you know, to get the, all these things, we have to construct road, we have to produce vehicles, we have to, you know, increase the different types of the fuel-based, you know, consumption. And all these activities produce, you know, carbon emission and F gases. If we compromise our development, you know, we cannot get the quality of life. And then we can maintain the, you know, carbon emission and, you know, F gases, but we cannot compromise our development. We have to continue it by finding the alternatives. That is the situation. We have a question how to do, how to go, you know, sustainability of the earth by maintaining the climate change. Another way, just like the due to the fire and other different types of factors, forest resources have been degrading. Land's dynamics has been, you know, changing, and all these things also generated or contribute to, you know, carbon emission and F gases. And that is the cause. It means if we have a more population, means more human activity, more, you know, deforestation, more disasters, and then after more, you know, emission of the carbon and more emission of the F gases, and its subsequent will be, you know, more, you know, change in climate, you know, climate change. That is the situation. And in this situation, you know, we have a question how to reduce it. There are different types of the, you know, modalities. One is the, you know, reduction of the causes. Another one is the reduction of the losses. One is, you know, mitigation talks about the, you know, reduces causes of the climate change, and adaptation talks about the reduces its losses by making resilient to the human resources. These are the two approaches, please remember. But question is, how, you know, developing countries like Nepal, when we talk about developing countries like Nepal, and why Nepal has to link with the climate change, why Nepal has to, you know, participate and contribute to stabilize, you know, climate change. Although, you know, almost, you know, developed countries have contributed to increase its carbon emission and F gases. That is the situation. But the, when we observe facts and figures of the Nepal, you can easily find out the, you know, climate change has induced many, you know, disasters, including flood, landslide, cyclone, and drought, and other different types of the problem. And when we observe the facts and figures, we found, you know, 2,000 million rupees per annum loss due to the, you know, loss of human life, human loss of infrastructure, loss of private property, loss of, you know, other different types of the, you know, assets. That is the situation. And it shows us the, if you ignore climate change, no problem, but the its impact happens in Nepal or in our country, in this situation, directly and indirectly, as a cause, as an effect, we have a certain relationship. In this way, we cannot escape from that transboundary issue. And without the responding that transboundary issues, we have initiated conservation of the forest resources under the two major modalities. One is community forest, another is the leisure forest. Our policy goal was to reduce poverty and local development along with the forest conservation. And another aspect, it was the decentralized devolution of the power to provide the right to the people or community on the resources for utilization, for conservation, for welfare. And that is the major policy logic. But in the context of the climate change, what happened? Initiation has been reducing causes or the drivers of the carbon emission and F-gases at some extent. Means Nepal has been contributing climate change stability through the forest conservation and management. And nowadays, IPCC has endorsed two policy framework or the carbon credit trading mechanisms. One is the CDM, another is the RED. And RED can provide the incentives to those countries and communities and private sector who have been involving to conserve forest resources. In this way, Nepal is a right country to get assess the such incentive, such mechanism. But Nepal has not initiated, has not enter such mechanism. In this way, Nepal has not received the incentives under the RED. In 2008 and 2010, we found ICMOD has initiated at some extent of the piloting RED mechanism in some community forest. And one of the community forest, that Kalimati was one of the community forest where ICMOD had piloted for RED mechanism. In terms of infrastructure development and awareness to the stakeholders. And on the basis of that, I had selected study area and for studying our role of the community forest at the global context under the RED mechanism. When I observe and when we conduct study, we have used the three methods. One is the explorative, another is the descriptive measures. Try to quantify the carbon trade, potential carbon trade, and after then we try to observe perspective of the stakeholders. And when we found, just like the at the first level, the status of the community forest was contributed by the time, resources and other different types of the materials by the stakeholders for getting the forest products, fodder for their livelihoods and livestock farming, and also certain amount of the money for community development. That was the situation. The poorest of the poor people have been contributing their time, their money as a membership fee. And third one is they also concern about the other issues. Look here. And just like it is a burden to the poorest of the poor people, please let's think about the when they will, they can use their leisure time for their own, productive activities. That is the situation. But when we observe its benefit is less than its cost to manage the community forest. And in that, in that connection, if we, feed that community forest mechanism under the rate mechanism, they will get the benefit. There was a huge potential. There was a huge potential of the carbon credit. And when we convert into the monetary value, we found if we enter the rate, that community forest would get the 41 times more income from the rate mechanism. And that would be more benefit than cost. And that incentive would improve to livelihood and income benefit and also the community development. That is the situation, please remember. In this situation, but the we have to develop the, we have to enter the rate mechanism by preparing properly our document, project and other things. But still it was going on. And in this situation, urgently we have to respond. We have to, enter our community forest in rate mechanism for getting more benefit to, our community forest stakeholders for their, welfare and development. And then, climate, our sacrifice will get the incentive. And all these things are, presented in my small book. And it is a theoretical and empirical, and it provides us the basic information about the rate and forest resources, carbon trading, along with the empirical results.